हेलो फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट्स अप। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल वेयर वी ऑल लर्न टू मेक इंटरेस्टिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स विद आर्डुइनो। फ्रेंड्स, यू मस्ट हैव सीन दैट व्हेन एवर वी आर ट्रैवलिंग बाय अ कार एंड इट स्टार्ट्स रेनिंग, द ड्राइवर हैज़ टू मैनुअली स्विच ऑन द कार वाइपर्स। फ्रेंड्स, द क्वेश्चन कम्स, कैन दिस बी डन ऑटोमेटिकली? Yes, it can be done automatically. Friends, today I have come up with a project where, according to the amount of rain, the wiper speed increases and decreases. Let me show you the demo of today's project. This is the project which we will do today. Our project's name is Automatic Car Wiper. So, as you can see, currently it's not raining, so the message is coming no rain, and none of our LEDs are glowing. Friends, now it's gonna rain a little. So as you can see, the message is coming that it is raining and amount is medium, and our two LEDs have started glowing. Now it's gonna rain a little more. So as you can see, it is coming that it is raining amount high, and see the speed of the wiper. Friends, and as soon as I take some water off, it has come that it is raining amount is medium. And with a little more water gone, it's come that amount low. And now watch the speed. And when I completely remove the water, it says that it's no rain. For making an automatic car wiper, we require a servo motor, a rain sensor, a LCD, one I2C module, a few male-to-male and male-to-female jumper wires, three LEDs, three resistors, an Arduino Uno, and a breadboard. Without further delay, let's get started. Friends, let me explain the construction for today's project. This is the project which we will do today. So, as you can see, this is our rain sensor, our Arduino Uno, our liquid crystal display 16x2, and this is our servo motor. So, friends, as you can see, this is our rain sensor. It has two parts. In the first part, this is the first part which helps in sensing the rain droplets. And friends, this is the part which gives conveys the information to Arduino Uno, which takes a respective action. So there are two ports on the rain sensor's first part which have been connected to this part of the rain sensor. This is the red wire being connected to 5 volts on Arduino Uno. This is the black wire connected to ground, and the blue wire has been connected to A0 on Arduino IDE. Sorry, Arduino Uno. So, and friends, this is a servo motor. The yellow one is the digital signal pin, which has been connected to pin number 9 on Arduino Uno. This is the VCC pin, which has been connected to 5 volts. And friends, this is the ground pin. Coming to the LCD, friends, we are using an I2C module for connecting the LCD. So instead of connecting all wires on these 16 ports with the help of I2C module, we can connect it with just 4 pins. So after connecting I2C on LCD, the black wire will be connected to ground. The red wire is for VCC. The blue wire is has been connected to A4. It is the SDL pin, which stands for data line. And this is the SCL pin connected to A5. This is for the clock. This is the clock line. Friends, this was the construction. Coming to the code part now. Friends, as you can see, this is our code. So first we have to include three libraries. First is a servo.h, which helps in controlling servo motor. This is the wire Library, and friends, this is the library for the LCD, which is liquid crystal underscore I2C dot H. Friends, to download this library, you can visit the link in the description below. And don't forget to download the library in the place where you have downloaded Arduino IDE on the File Explorer. So, friends, I have also used three LEDs and I have defined them on pin number 8, 10, and 12. Friends, there are some basic commands for the starting of LCD. So, we first start our LCD. Friends, this is for the servo motor. We are attaching it on pin number 7. And as you can see, now it is first coming on the introduction part on the LCD. So, as you can see, I have first written a command called lcd.setcursor. That means it will set the module, the LCD, on the first line's 0th character. So, it will print automatic on that. And on the second line, it's going to print car wiper. And we are defining the LEDs as output. So, friends, in this part of the code, we will be using the values which are analog read by the Arduino Uno and are stored in a variable called sensor value. Friends, this is the conditions part. So when there's no rain on the rain sensor, so it is going to display as no rain and all LEDs will be off. In the second case, when the value is between 800 and 600, it will print that on the LCD that it is raining and the amount is low, and one of our LEDs will switch on, and it will start moving the servo motor as I showed in the demo before. Now it is coming to the medium level. It will display it is raining amount medium when the value will be between 600 and 460, and this helps in adjusting the speed of the servo motor. And friends, this is the last part which helps in rotating the servo motor so fast when amount is high, and it will switch on all three LEDs. Friends, this was the code part. Coming to the output now. As automatic car wiper. So as you can see, currently it's not raining, so the message is coming no rain, and none of our LEDs are glowing. Friends, now it's gonna rain a little. So as you can see, the message is coming that it is raining and amount is medium, and our two LEDs have started glowing. Now it's gonna rain a little more. So as you can see, it is coming that it is raining, amount high, and see the speed of the wiper. Friends, and as soon as I take some water off, it has come that it is raining, amount is medium. And with a little more water gone, it's come that amount low. And now watch the speed. And when I completely remove the water, it says that it's no rain. Friends, this was today's project using a rain sensor and a servo motor to make an automatic car wiper. If you like the project, give a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Stay home, stay safe, keep learning. Thank you.